this be your own day.
Now, the one point occurred to me, we discussed in the morning, saying that we had come to the point where when we see the observer as the observed, then that is death, essentially, is what you said.
Right.
Now, this raises a question, if the self is nothing but an image, right? Then what is it that dies? You see, if the image dies, that's nothing, right? That's not death.
Yeah, that's right.
So is there something real that dies?
There's biological death.
We're not discussing that at the moment. You were discussing some kind of death.
I was discussing, when we were talking this morning,
yeah.
I was trying to point out if there is no image at all,
yes.
If there is no variety of images in my consciousness, mm-hmm. I am dead. There is death.
Well, that's the point. It's not clear. What is it that has died? You see, death implies something has died.
Died? The images have died. Me is dead.
But is that something, is that a genuine death in the sense
of that's what I want to call. That's what I want to. Is it a verbal comprehension?
Or more deeply, is there something that has to die? You see, I'm trying to say something real.
Something.
Yeah. In other words, if an organism dies, I see that to a point. Something real has died, you see.
Yes, something real has died.
Now, but when the self dies.
But I have accepted so far,
yeah.
The self has been an astonishingly real thing.
Yes.
You come along, you three come along and tell me that that image is fictitious. Mm-hmm. And I understand it. And I'm a little frightened that when that dies, when there is no image, there's an ending to something.
Yeah, well, what is it that ends?
Ah, right. What is that ends?
Yeah, because is it something real that ends? Or you see, you could say an ending of an image is no ending at all, right?
At all. What?
If it's only an image that ends, that's an image of ending. I mean, I'm trying to say that it's not nothing much ends if it's only an image, right?
Yes, that's what I want to get at.
Is that, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
If it is merely an ending of an image,
right, then there's nothing much.
There's nothing.
No, it's like turning off the television.
Turning, yes. I mean, that leaves me nothing.
Right. Is that what?
Well, that's where we have that to. Is that what death is, or is there something deeper that dies?
Oh, very much deeper.
Something deep has dies.
Yes.
Well, how about the image making process? Would you want to? Right, is that a something?
No. I would say. It is not the end of the image, which is death, but something much deeper than that.
Yeah.
But it's still not the death of the organism, you see.
Still not the death of organism. But of course, the organism will know that.
Will go on
will
up to a point, right?
Up to a point, yes. Till a disease, accident, mm-hmm. old age, or senility, right. And so on. But death. Is it the ending of the image, mm-hmm. which is fairly simple and fairly, acceptable and known,
right.
But logically or even actually,
mm-hmm.
but that, yes, but it's like, a very shallow pool.
Yes.
You have taken away the little water,
right.
And there is nothing but mud left behind. There's nothing. So, is there something much more?
That dies?
No. Not that dies, but the meaning of death.
Well,
is there something more than the image that dies, or does death have a meaning beyond the death of the image?
Of course, that's what we are asking.
That's the question.
That's what we are
asking. Is there something about death that is bigger than the death of the image?
Obviously, it must be.
That, will this include the death of the organism, this meaning?
Yes. Death of the organism might go on. The organism might go on, but eventually come to an end.
Yeah, but if we were to see what death means as a whole, universally, then we would also see what the death of the organism means.
Yes. Right?
Along
yes.
with, but and is there some meaning also to the death of the self-image? The same meaning.
That's only, I should say, that's only a very small part.
That's very small.
Right.
That's a very, very small mm-hmm. part.
But then, is there, say, you know, one could think there might be the death of the self-image, then there might be a process or a structure beyond the self-image that might die, and that creates the self-image.
Yes, that is thought.
That's thought. Now, are you discussing the death of thought?
Yes, that's only also, again, superficial.
It's very small.
Very small.
And is there something beyond thought in us that should
That's
die?
What I want to get at.
Yeah, we're trying to get at the meaning
we're not quite
of death.
Clear.
Yeah, which is beyond the death of the self, thought,
and
or the
thought.
Image.
No, just look. The image dies. Image wipes, that's
right.
fairly simple.
Right.
It's a very shallow affair.
Right.
Then there's the ending of thought,
right.
which is the ending of dying to thought.
But you say thought is deeper than the image, but still not very deep.
Not very deep. So we have,
right.
we have removed the maker of image
mm-hmm.
and the image itself.
Right, right.
Now, is there something more?
In what sense something more? Something more that exists or something more that has to die? Or
is it something creative that happens?
No, we're going to find out.
But I mean, your question is not clear when you say, is there something more?
Is there, no, is... Is that all death? Is that death?
Oh, I see. Is that all that death is?
Me, yes.
This is death.
No. I understand image, maker of image.
Right.
But that's a very shallow affair.
Right. So then there's something
and I
else.
Say, is that all? Is that the meaning of death?
Right. Hmm. You mean, I think I'm getting with you. Is that the meaning of death only in that little part? Or is there a meaning that's bigger?
Death must have something enormously significant.
Yeah,
right.
Now you're saying death has a meaning, is significant for everything, for
yes.
the whole of life.
Whole of life.
Yes. Now, first, could you say, you know, why do you say it? Do you say, in other words, you know, at first, it's not generally accepted if we're thinking of the viewer that death is that sort of thing. In other words, the way we live now, death is just
the end.
It's, and you try to forget about it, you know.
Yeah.
And try to make it unobtrusive and so on.
But if you, as you three have worked at it, pointed out, my life has been in a turmoil.
Mm-hmm.
And my life has been a constant conflict, anxiety, all the rest of it.
Right.
That's been my life. I've clung to the known. And therefore, the death is the unknown.
Right.
So I'm afraid of that. And you come along, we come along and say, look, death is partly the ending of the image, the maker of the image,
mm-hmm.
And death must have much more greater significance than merely this empty saucer.
Well, if you can make it more clear why it must have, you see.
Why it must have, because...
Why must it?
Is life just a shallow, empty pool? Empty mud at the end of it?
Why would you assume it's anything else?
I want to know.
That's.
But I mean, even if it is something else, I have to ask, why is it that death is the key to understanding that, do you see?
Because it's the ending of everything.
All right.
Everything.
Reality,
mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
and all my concepts, images, the end of all the memories.
Well, that's in the ending of thought, right?
Ending of thought. And also it means ending of time.
Mm-hmm. Ending of time.
Ending the time coming to a stop totally.
Mm-hmm.
And there is no future
yes.
in the sense of past meeting the present and carrying on.
Psychologically speaking.
Yes, psychologically speaking. Of course, we
yeah.
are psychologically.
Where we still
speaking.
Admit the future and the cause.
Of course.
Right. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ending, psychological ending of everything.
Right.
That's what is there.
Right.
And when the organism dies, then everything ends for that organism.
Of course. When the organism, this organism dies, it's finished.
Right.
But wait a minute. If I don't end the image, the stream of image making goes on.
Yes, well, and again, it won't, it's not too clear where it goes on. Do you see in other people or in...
It manifests itself in other people.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That is, I die.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Organism.
I die, the organism dies, and at the last moment is I'm still with the image I have.
Yeah, so then what happens to that?
That's what I'm saying. That image is has its continuity. With the other rest of the images, your image, my image.
Right.
Your image is not different from mine.
Right. We share that.
No, no, not share it. It's not different.
Right.
It may have a little more frill, a little bit more color, but essentially the image, my image is your image.
Right.
Now, so there is this constant flow of image making.
Mm-hmm. Well, where does it take place?
Huh?
In people?
It is there. It manifests itself in people.
Oh, you feel that it's broader than, in some way, it's more general, more universal.
Yes, much more universal.
Mm-hmm. That's rather, yeah.
Huh?
I say it's rather strange, I mean, to think of that.
Yes.
It's there.
It is a... It's
it
like a river.
Yeah.
Like a river, it's there.
It's there.
And it manifests itself
in
streams,
people.
Which we call people.
That stream is the maker of images and image.
Right.
So in other words, you're saying the image does not originate only in one brain, but in some sense it's universal.
Universal, quite
yeah,
right.
But it's not clear. I mean, you're not only saying that it's just the sum of the effects of all the brains, but are you implying something more?
It's the effect of all the brains.
Yeah.
Hmm? And it manifests itself when in people, as they're born, genes and all the rest of
that.
Now, is that all? That's a yes.
Mm-hmm.
Does death leave me, does death bring about this sense of enormous, endless energy which has no beginning and no end. Or is it just, I got rid of my images, and the image maker is, I can stop it. It's very simple, it can be stopped, and yes. But I haven't touched much deeper things. There must be, life must have infinite depth.
Yes, now the death which opens that up.
Death opens that up.
Is the death, you say, of the but we said it's more than the death of the image making. See, this is what is not clear. Is there, for example, I'm trying to say something real which is blocking that from realizing itself?
Yes. Is blocking itself through image and thought maker, the maker.
Now that's what's blocking it, though. The image making and thought making is blocking this greater.
Yeah.
Blocking that, right.
But there's still other blocks, deeper blocks.
That's what I was trying to get at.
That
there are deeper blocks that are real.
That are real. Now.
That's.
And they really have to die, aren't they?
That's just it.
So would that be like this stream that you're talking about that's there?
No. There is. There's a stream of sorrow, isn't there?
Yes. Now, in what sense is sorrow deeper than the image?
Yes.
It is.
Well, that's important.
It is.
You think so?
Don't you?
I do. I think
no. Be careful, sir. It's very serious.
That's right.
I mean, would you say sorrow and suffering are the same, or just different words?
Different words.
All
sorrow
right,
and
just to clear it up.
Deeper than this image making is sorrow.
Isn't it? man has lived with sorrow million years.
Well, could we say a little more about sorrow? See, what is it? You see, it's more than pain, you see.
Oh, much more than pain. Much more than loss. Much more than losing my son and my parent or this or that.
It's deeper than that.
It's much deeper than that.
Mm. It goes beyond the image, beyond thought.
Of course, beyond thought.
Beyond what we would ordinarily call feeling.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Feeling, thought. Now, can that end?
Well, let me, before you go, are you saying that the stream of sorrow, if I can be so naive, is a different stream from the stream of image making? If you had to say it's there, is it two different streams or?
No, it's part of the stream.
Part of the same stream.
Stream, but much deeper.
Much deeper.
Well,
right.
I was saying, and there's a very deep stream. Image making is on the surface of this
stream.
The wave is on the surface.
But
right?
We have been left with that. You see, I want to penetrate.
Well, could you say we've understood the waves on the surface of this stream, which we call image making?
Image making.
Right.
And whatever disturbances in sorrow comes out on the surface as image making.
That's right.
So now we got to go deep.